Alright, let's see what we got moving here. Alright, it jumped. Maybe he'll stop. Yeah. He's going a little bit too fast right there to be stopping. That train I was on didn't even have no mid or back DPU, so I don't think it was going much farther than Roanoke, and if it did, it was going to be taking the right-hand hook north of the yard and kind of heading up towards the Lynchburg area. Come on, baby, stop. I doubt you are, though. There's a couple of good rides. Man, nope. Well, I didn't want that anyway. No DPUs. Yeah, he won't be going to Hagerstown or Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania like that. He'll take that right hook north of the yard in Roanoke. Hell, at least I got a good spot. Getting up that hump there. Yeah, I got some food left over too that I cooked earlier. It's about 6 o'clock, so better start getting my nighttime stuff out, my flashlight and whatnot. But it's really hid good back here. There's a parking lot up there, but it's so far out on this end, the business is way over there, so no one really ever parks there unless they're wanting to get exercise. Anyway, well, since it was getting dark, which it is, I figured I'd move from my camp a little closer to the main line in case something stops. I don't want to say in case, it will. Too far, this line's over. That's the main one and two. They'll stop on those two. See, all I gotta do is walk around this one car here and be able to get over. And in case I have to wait a little good while, I got a Cadillac Grainger. I was going to show one a little more close up. That being the only hole through the side to see in or out. Now, this type Grainger, that's the kind I rode last night here to Radford. We call it the, well, I won't say the full name, but we call it the LIP, L-I-P, the LIP Grainger. It's a little bit higher on the walls. As long as you lay down, cars at crossings can't really see you. Workers can't see in on you if they're monkeying around with something. I mean, you got a good flat spot to roll out. Now, these are kind of like your regular Grainers that you can ride them at night and get away with it, but I will not ride one of these during the day. So you can just see right in from 4-foot level. It's a little higher. There's some that are even down this low where you can see in. None of this is here. But let's hop up. Yeah, and the brake piston is on. This is just a cut of cars anyway. Not going anywhere yet. That right there is where a valve that air escapes. When that engineer dumps the air to set the brakes, air comes out of that nozzle there, that rubber. And it goes really loud. I remember my dog Bubba one time, before I knew that, my dog Bubba was rolled up in a ball right next to that when we dumped air. I thought there was going to be dog poop all over. But that's my second to a favorite grainer. I like them double barrel shotgun grainers. Two holes on the end, but see, nobody's going to see inside there. And that lip, even higher up. The only thing is them holes, no matter how much you try to plug them up, you're going to lose something. I've lost battery, power banks. I remember losing a couple of fifths of vodka down on beer. God, anything that isn't attached can go down that hole. Matter of fact, battery pack was the last thing I lost down one. But, yeah, some of them come with little, you'll see these round plastic lids that go over them holes. And the people who load the grain or plastic pellets or whatever they're hauling will place them little caps there to keep product from spilling all over the floor beneath. And it's easier to sweep, and water can drain out of them holes. But yeah, them caps. I actually had one on my last ride. Let's see if we can find a cap somewhere. Yeah, that end, that's the good end to ride. I just showed you those two. Now, sometimes they're facing the other way, and you ain't got no choice but to ride with all that air reservoir and all the brake pipe and the release pin and all that. See, there's a good end. I think it's the A end. Yeah, and that's the B end. See all the stuff. I mean, you can do it. I have many times, probably as much as I have the right way. I rode this way. But that Cadillac grainer up there, I'm just gonna, if I have to, if I get too tired of waiting, I'll just sleep up in there, because this ain't going nowhere. Thing's about to rust to the track. Anyway, thought I'd kind of show that. And I thought that was the Operation Clean Sweep. A lot of them have tags called Operation Clean Sweep. And it's where companies that unload cars. It's kind of like, hey, clean your mess up. You know, don't leave it for the next guy. You know, if you spill stuff down in here, you know, clean it up. But you find the weirdest things here. Tires, wheels, dead cats all dried out like leather. You find anything, the weird stuff. Yep, and golf balls. I think people, when they change a tire or something, a green car is sitting by and they're like, whoop, there's a good way to get rid of it. Again, this is Radford. R-A-D. F-O-R-D. college police. Anyway, yeah, I gotta do something about that beard. It is really getting tangly. Alright. Well, I hear a northbound. Yeah, that plant right there with that stack. Me and Colby were sleeping over there right around that tree line right there, and a security guard that works there ran us off. Well, he could be stopping. Got them expensive cars up front. That's why he had them auto racks up front. See that too often, where they got an EOT on the DPU. You see them on a caboose too, if there's nobody in it, but that just signifies that DPU will stay with that entire train until they dump all that freight they just brought in. They'll detach it from the back, take those engines off the front and leave it. Probably pick up another one and turn right back around, come back to where that one's just coming from. Called a unit train or a shuttle, like grain shuttle. All right, it's almost dark. coming into Bristol. I'm gonna be right by MLK Road. Everybody's gonna see me get off. Virginia. Now the old train depot is right on the Tennessee-Virginia line. It's a wedding photographer place now. Warming up really good. Sumac, don't bother me. He's just kind of coasting into the crew change. concrete plant. We ain't got but about another half mile. I catch out south here a lot. Hill, Mount Everest climb, Mount Kilimanjaro. Columbia Boulevard. There's Columbia. Yeah, my camp's right there. Maybe we'll make it down to Mary Street overpass. Here comes that road. I do not want to be seen getting off. That morning I got hit. Yep, right there is where I got hit.
Oh, shit.
Come on, keep going. Thought that was a cop. Oh, good, Boy, that's going to be a tight squeeze. Boy, this just keeps getting worse. Be hell walking that. Come on, keep going. Shit, I ain't going to fit. Oh, there we go. God, dog, that was perfect. There's Mary Street going across. And there comes the cops for me. Yeah, that stuff, that's cottonseed. Yeah, I always throw my bucket off at an angle. Where it lands at an angle. Sometimes it'll dig in. And sometimes not. I really don't need this water bottle anymore, but I gotta put this dang thing down. Alright. Wish I was up there. There's a good hot dog joint on that side. Alright. I sure ain't going that way. Heck, the yard office is right up there. I ain't ever got this close to the yard office. All right, I made it up top. I had to cross over that boxcar. That's the boxcar I rode in. Went to that little road and walked up this feeder road and then down here. I was hoping he'd be rolling by now and I could film it, but he's not. But that's the boxcar I was in. Of course, the door was open on that side by that wall, so I had to cross over and then run out. There's Bristol's little yard. Some lady stopped and told me there was a church up here that feeds at 11, so I'm gonna try and make it up there since they're feeding and it's so close. Let's see if I can. That was one of the better rides I've ever had in a boxcar. Anyway, I hope you liked the video. Thank you. It was a good trip. This is the train I rode from Radford. Here comes my boxcar. I didn't know I was that close to the front. Let's see what all he had on here. Empty. Cadillac. Another lip grinder. actually may be that Atlanta train. He'll go down to Cleveland, Tennessee, and then hit that split and go left down to Atlanta. I'm at the old Bristol train depot. Yeah, it's a wedding photography place now.